Back again up in this entertaining for you. Come for my M's, you get this double, double. Straight to your bubble. In this game because I love the trouble. So watch your tone if you don't want to rubble. You pop, pop, like my, did you forget we know you're not wet? Any inch of the real, so stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud ooh. Jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rang, yes, them cannons rang. Make sure you fold already when you see the gang. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Having some fun, why you out on your run? Taking victory laps, I'm in the hood with them ones. Catch me out in Decatur with some meat and potatoes. Waffle House in Atlanta, I hit the blue flame late. With them two-tone gates, who you know gon' face? I see them keep trying, professional imitators. Rep, where's the flag? Now you're making me mad. With 47, get that, you better get back. Like my, did you forget we know you're not wet? Any inch of the real, so stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud ooh. Jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rang, yes, them cannons rang. Make sure you fold already when you see the gang. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chiller, click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
Yeah.
You got to find out what the cow.
Yeah.
I find then I get love.
shift off. It ain't nothing to cut the off. Stop frying, don't let it get soft. Covered in yolk, in yolk. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's just how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
It's just a little hit for the summer. Big deal. Whoa, here I go. I'm jumping out of green balloon. Geronimo, man, I like big wheels. 24, and I let the paint drip like the hose. Whoa, big cars. Suicide doors, I got scores. You don't know my life, my life is hard. Make me wake up in the morning, 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 morning. Chinchilla for the whistle, cause I swear to clip. Queen Latifah, Rego, living single, but I'm busy like a clerm. You was on for a minute. Miss me with that, put that. I'll be back in a minute with my good vibes, good vibes. Man, I like good signs and good. Plus I got my recline and I'm watching Cita on the Wi-Fi.
I cannot just go away. Can you bring me back to my old way? Tell my mom and dad I'm praying for some better days. Only good vibes Friday to Friday. I'm looking for a highway to
NFL is on EA Sports, and we are in Silicon Valley at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. The scene a short time ago, this crowd, they love their 49ers, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. And we're ready for football as the 49ers get set to do battle with the Tennessee Titans. Randy Bullock now to put toe to leather, and we are underway from Santa Clara. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line and beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
At their own 22-yard line.
They'll run on first down. It's Mitchell, and he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play at second down.
At the 23.
They fake the handoff. Now Lance. Oh, he'll look downfield for Kittle. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Throwing is Lance on third down. To the right side, it's caught by Mitchell. And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. Tannehill and the Titans come up now, first and 10, just shy of the 30. There to stop him on the defensive side, Fred Warner.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Now it's second and 9. And now on the pitch, the ball's loose. And the ball ends up out of bounds, so it'll be a loss on the play. Well, obviously you never want to fumble, but if you do, good to be towards the sideline. It saves them the possession.
Saves the embarrassment, saves it going down on the play sheet as a turnover. But I still think it should go to the defense, even if they don't recover it. If you give up the football, you gave up the football.
Agree to disagree, I guess.
Can you tell what I played?
Yeah, you played defense. Yeah. I'll let you go.
I took a shot.
And down he goes. The 49ers get there. Nick Bosa drops him for a loss of 14 yards, and it also brings up fourth down. On is Kern, the punter, to send this one away. They'll call it a punt of 44 yards. The return was for 7. And the Niners will go on offense. First and 10. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive.
And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Lance now on first down. Trying for Ayuk, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Bud Dupree. Look at the big man rumble. Past the 20. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Bullock good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Taken in at the 3. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told him, they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice game.
On first down, Mitchell. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
Now a throw here to his running back, and he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans' 41-yard line. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Play action, now it's Lance. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And he works free. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful. And that strength was on display there.
And as a former defender, I can tell you with certainty, those are the ones that have you losing sleep at night. I would not like to be in that film room on Tuesday going over that one. Just a pretty poor effort defensively, and it leads to a big play.
And they will finally get to him, but a great return has set him up first and goal at the 5. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because 2 interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen. They'll try and run for it with Henry. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Derrick Henry, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Titans are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Here's Bullock now for the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0.
Makes the score tight. 49ers-0.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects him.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw four or five picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Shotgun now for Lance. Escaping the pressure right. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Well, that was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Checks this one down. It's Mitchell. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Now a play fake. Lance. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll just get rid of it. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Second and 10. Again, they'll throw it with Lance. Oh, he'll look downfield for Kittle. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Here's Lance. He'll dump that one off to Mitchell. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they're having panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise, and start to put together some drives.
Kevin Byard up to make the tackle.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
They're 2 for 2 on third down conversions on this drive. This one tough. They need 9 yards on third down. Throwing now is Lance. Man open, that's Deebo Samuel. And he is going to have a Niners first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And Lance's throw complete here to Ayuk. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Flushed out right. That is caught by the tight end, Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers. George Kittle there to make the grab. And the 49ers are back within a score. Coaches must really like to see that from the quarterback, because he's had the interceptions in this game, but they're able to connect on the touchdown pass.
And teammates love to see that, because they know that they miss blocks during a game, but they come back and make them later on. They miss tackles, right? They miss making plays, but the spotlight is magnified on your quarterback. And when he stands up to the pressure and comes back and throws a touchdown pass after throwing some picks earlier, they feel great about that guy.
And likewise for him personally, as a rookie quarterback, has to give him more confidence. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway.
And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. And Lance now to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Mitchell. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out.
And that's a nice throw right there. And I'll tell you what I've seen in recent times, and actually watched a presentation in the offseason from a college offensive coordinator that showed about 10 different drills that he runs with his quarterbacks to show them how to get out of the pocket, how to get comfortable when they're doing so, and to make plays under that type of duress. That's an example of what we're seeing the colleges deliver to the NFL.
And that nearly a turnover, but it's incomplete. Oh, fortunate to retain possession there, and it's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. On play action, Lance. This will be caught. It's Samuel. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Lance looking to throw it. Flush to his right. And that is incomplete.
I like the play call. Roll him out. Give him a chance to run it or throw it. In this situation, he decided to fling it, but couldn't find his man open.
Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Off of play action, here's Lance. Forced out to his left. That'll be caught by Ayuk. Touchdown, 49ers. A 9-yard touchdown there. And the Niners are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Gold with the extra point, and we are tied here in the second quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And the clock reads 30 seconds to go, so really not a whole lot of time to speak of. And the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
So many times we've seen him try to escape the pocket and do something with his legs, but in this case, the pressure was too intense and he made the wise choice to just get rid of the football and make sure no one was going to get it.
Off play action, Tannehill. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And a potential turning point as he'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half.
You can easily see the logic. It's a tie game. They just wanted to press it a little bit right before the half, hoping to get one more score.
Now, easy to second guess the result, but now you have to think after that interception, just a field goal, and they're behind at the break.
Yeah, I think at the half, the head coach just says, look, that's on me. I wanted to press it, but it's because I believe in you guys.
Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Mitchell.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. On first down, Lance. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked by Kevin Byard. And the Titans are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning, threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's the guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Both these teams, no doubt, making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Godden, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. It's a tied football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tied game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't put anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
And this defense going to bring out a couple extra DBs here on third and a yard. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. A first down carry for Henry. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. A couple of first downs have him to the 40 now on first and 10. He gets it left side to Johnson. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Third quarter, all tied up. This is second and 10. Tannehill with a play fake to Henry. He'll throw instead. Escaping the pressure right. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice game. Touchdown! Touchdown, Titans! Well, Derrick Henry, the league's leading rusher in 2019. You wouldn't think a man that big could motor like that, but he can all right, and he proved it right there. Extra point up and good by Bullock, and the lead is now 21-14. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, what's interesting is
they got his man complete. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Credit the tackle for loss to Harold Landry.
I know they'd love to take some heat off of that young quarterback, but so far, not much in the running game, and this won't help things either. A loss on that play.
Lance with a tap forward on the jet sweep. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on him before he could get much out of it.
Got an extra defensive back out there for the Titans now here for third down. Go! 54. Lance going to throw. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there that brings up fourth. Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this ball is going to be down now right at the 10-yard line. Good spot.
Well, someone's going to be happy with that effort. You know who else is going to be happy? His defense.
Absolutely.
He's created a very long field for that offense to try to traverse.
And he got some help from Mr. Football there, checking up nicely. Good English on that punt. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
89 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. From the 22, here's second and eight. They'll fake the handoff. Now Tannehill. And that'll be incomplete.
Well, listen, when you've got the lead, there's absolutely no sense trying to fit a ball in where you shouldn't. You can see the coaching in his head taking place on that play because he saw he had a receiver in the area. And he just put it well over his head out of harm's way.
The Titans on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and eight. Now Tannehill. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. So two first downs, and that moves the ball to the 42 now, first and 10. Tenth carry now for Derrick Henry.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and 10. They'll run with Henry. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. And he'll go down at the 28. They'll run on first down. Henry, and he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Now a second down and six. Tannehill going to turn and give this to Henry. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
On third down, it's Henry.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave them with a third and about four more for a first. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead. Maybe a free play here for Tannehill.
Ooh,
and he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag.
It's just a little hit for the summer. Big deal.
warm day outside by Minnesota standards, but then again, it is still summer. Either way, the AC is working just fine at U.S. Bank Stadium in the Twin Cities. The scene a short time ago, this crowd decked out in purple, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football, folks, as the Vikings get set to do battle with the Los Angeles Rams. The holiday season is upon us. We've got the gift of the NFL as we're underway here in Week 16. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. Play here to start the drive. That'll net him 14 yards as they pick up the first.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
They'll run here with Akers. And that one goes for about six as he's taken down just shy of the 45.
So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise. Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say all the right things.
Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. The D-tackle Sheldon Richardson came barreling in for the sack.
Well, on that one, they go with a play fake, CD, but I don't think anybody really was fooled. All eyes were fixated on the quarterback, and they got him to the ground.
And to run this play successfully, you've got to make sure that everyone is doing their part. You actually have to sell this play. You've got to sell the run action. Otherwise, why do you stop at the running back? You just run straight for the quarterback and put him on the ground. Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Second and six at the 47-yard line.
Stafford going to give this to Akers. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Here's Stafford. Man open, it's Kopp. He's got it. And he is going to have a Rams first down. He needed five. He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards.
First down, Los Angeles.
Off the fake to Akers. Here's Stafford. Oh, a nice catch by Kopp. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
That is one heck of a catch right there. Got his eye on it the whole way and able to make the grab one-handed. Very nicely done and for a nice chunk of yardage, too.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, Stafford. Eluding the pressure right. Looking to Stafford, runs and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the five.
And the Vikings are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive.
Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football, but at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. Cousins' throw here into the hands of the receiver, Judy. A gain of six there on first.
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four at the 26-yard line.
Second and four.
The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. And that's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. They're looking for Judy, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Extra point by Gay is up and good, and that makes the score 7-0.
Vikings nothing.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
Taken at the goal line.
And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. As the season winds down and you look at them in totality, you know, the offense has struggled. The defense has been pretty good, so I would imagine the changes this offseason may be more on the offensive side of the ball.
And this is where we always hear the term complementary football, because as you noted, the defense has played well enough for them to win games, and the offense has held them back. So they've got to reward that defense by improving on offense. I don't know if you make a change of quarterback, running back, tight end, it doesn't matter. Get better players, better system, so they can play to the standards of the defense, and the win column will result.
Here's a quick throw to Thielen, and he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. So, Charles, defensively here, you're going up against a veteran quarterback. He's got a lot of know-how, a ton of savvy, but guy who's not the most mobile of quarterbacks, what's the plan of attack?
You spend all week pumping up your defensive front. Your defensive tackles, your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys who go after the quarterback the most, because you know that he's not going to run and beat you consistently throughout the game. You can rush more aggressively off the edge and even up the middle, because even if he evades you, he's not going to go very far. You have a lot more confidence going after him in the pocket.
Cousins now. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, they've moved the ball okay here in these first two drives, but this one's going to, again, amount to nothing. They've got to start dialing up some plays that allow them to finish drives with points.
Now Jordan Berry on to kick this one away. He punted four times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Now a throw here to his running back. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. Three catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second and 11 now. From the gun, here's Stafford. That's out to the flat for Akers. It'll go as a gain of 4. And they're going to have a third down.
You know, you're following up on this head coach and the pressure that he is under. CD, I want to switch it to you because you've been on winning teams, but I know you've been in similar situations too where things just are not going well. How do you approach that as a player?
It's a tough approach, Brandon, because you actually have to do the opposite of what you would think. You know, in your mind, you're thinking, I redouble my efforts, I go harder. In a sense, you have to back off a little bit. You have to do a little bit less. Do what you're supposed to do, but don't take on the pressures of doing more and trying to do your teammates' jobs as well. If you do that, that's really going to lead you to more issues.
So that's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
Again, it's Stafford. They'll get this one to Kopp, complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line.
And a nice milestone reached on that last throw is here late in the season. He goes over 4,000 yards passing.
And he's really thrown the ball well all season long, had some big games along the way. He's inspired his receiving corps to go out and make plays for him in each and every ball game.
Stafford on first down. Flushed out right. A big hole right side. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. Last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was. Well, he did get a taste the previous week. He got into the end zone trying his best to get there in this game. So far, he's been denied.
Second down and goal. Stafford. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A. Bryson Hopkins, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Rams add on to their lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that'll make the score 14 to zip.
14. Vikings nothing.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Kene Nwangu now out of his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. That's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
From the 22, Cousins. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Von Miller has now recorded 10 sacks on the season. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That one into the hands of Thielen, complete. They do get 9, but it leads to fourth down.
I think that call was made not so much to try and get the first down, although they would have taken it if they could have gotten it, but to give their punter a little bit of space and try and help out their defense.
Yeah, they got the safe completion on third. No return, but it goes down as just a punt of 31 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. It's been a good first half so far. They're up 14 to nothing. Points here, they could really put them in command before intermission.
Yep.
The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. C.J. Mosley, the linebacker, making sure his presence is felt. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. A shotgun snap for Stafford. DeAndre Hopkins making the catch. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. That's 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. Once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And that is incomplete. But the pressure there on third down, forcing the errant pass. Fourth down coming up. So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense. Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10.
26, Mike. 26, Mike. You ain't going nowhere.
Working out of the gun, Cousins. That's complete to the receiver, Thielen. And they will rally and stop him short of the first down. They get him to the ground at the 26. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up fourth. Here's Jordan Berry now, as he's on to punt for Minnesota. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and give these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Looking to throw again on second down. Stafford gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee. The start for them near flawless. Defense gets them a 3 and out. 2 quick pass connections on offense.
So that's how a team works together. Just what you described. Get them the ball, give them a little momentum, and they're capitalizing off it.
And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. A big play that time through the air. 31 yards.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
Stafford's throw pulled in by Hopkins. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. So we've come to halftime. It's the visiting Rams taking the lead to the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. And how about this line out of the locker room, an onside kick attempt. And they've got it. They recovered it. But hang on now, though. There's a penalty flag down. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Cousins gives way to Cook. And he's got some space here. There he goes, right side.
You thought you had it.
Touchdown,
you thought you had it.
Vikings. Boy, the word with Dalvin Cook, he is explosiveness. I'm not sure there's anybody in the league that has the acceleration that he does, and he put it to good effect there.
And that's why he's one of the best running backs in the game today, because this run combined all the elements. Started with patience, and he was just waiting for the right lane to materialize. Then once he saw it, he used his speed and escapability in tandem and turned this into a tremendous play.
And he covered a lot of ground on that one, as evidenced by the final total there on Next Gen Stats. Point after, up and good. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Rams take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
set to begin their next drive. The Rams offense at the line. And their lead cut in half by that touchdown a moment ago. They are up 7 as they begin this drive, 1st and 10. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon. Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Now a play fake and it's Stafford. He's going to air it out deep for Woods. He's got a man complete. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Robert Woods, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Rams add on to their lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And it's now 21-7.
21, Vikings 7.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
A running play there, going to get 11 as they get a quick first down.
And that's why Dalvin Cook is the Minnesota Vikings' featured back. You put the ball in his hands, good things happen. 2nd in the NFL last year in rushing with 1,557 yards. And that's now back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons with 30 combined total touchdowns. What a player is Dalvin Cook. Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Room to run past midfield. He gets it across the 50 and down to the 48.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 81 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. Down throw for Cousins, and a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete. But the passing windows are just not there, and that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
Here's 2nd and 10. From the gun, it's a give to Cook. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Now Cousins. Open man. He completes it to Judy. And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to 4th down.
Big stop, G. Big stop. Let's go.
Hey,
From the gun, here's Cousins. Looking for Thielen, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Ernest Jones. And the Rams will take over here just shy of the 30. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Brings up 2nd and 4.
Ready? 180! Monday! Hurry up, get set!
Out of the gun, Stafford. He'll check this down to Akers out of the backfield. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
They'll try the jet sweep. Stafford pops it forward. And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Viking territory.
And a lot of times, these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
2nd down and 3. Now Stafford. Trying to find Kupp, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Eric Kendricks. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it. And sometimes they try too hard, and they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10.
43-yard line.
To throw his Cousins. This will be caught. Judy. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
And he gets it down close to the 10-yard line. 93 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. 3 yards remain for 2nd down. Cousins. Yeah, he's got it.
That's good for a Minnesota Vikings. First and goal at the 1-yard line.
One quarter remains here in week 16. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Trying the power game with Ham. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. His 2nd rushing touchdown of the year and 3rd overall. And the Vikings have made it a 1-score game again here in the 4th. Point after, right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this 4th quarter. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close, 1-score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping Chili on the other side of the ball, said, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. Because if there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Going right back to Akers. And he'll get this up only to about the 33.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The Rams on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. He finds Hopkins complete. And he is going to have a Rams first down, and he's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on 3rd and 2.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
That's so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. Stafford now to throw. Flush to his right. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45.
He's starting to fall into the category of not fair. Because when he's on target throwing the ball, he's dangerous. But when you add in his ability to make plays with his feet, almost impossible.
Yeah, exactly. They've had trouble stopping him in the secondary. This time they've got the great coverage. Oh, he can run too.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Everson Griffin, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up 2nd down. Another try after the 1st down sack. Stafford under pressure, and they got to him again. Sheldon Richardson able to record his 5th sack of the season.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a 3rd and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Third and long, it's Stafford. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Sheldon Richardson in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. Here's Johnny Hecker now as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Vikings will take over here 1st and 10. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And it feels like the momentum has shifted. They scored, then their defense forces that last punt. Now the pressure comes, and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Leonard Floyd has now recorded 10 sacks on the season. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now 2nd down and 22 yards to go. Cousins. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up 3rd down. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is 3rd and long. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now 4th down.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
So from their own end zone here, this kicks away. It's just a 32-yard punt with no return. And the Rams are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over. On 1st down at Stafford.
pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down.
That's Anthony Barr coming in from his linebacker spot to bring him to the ground.
And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Back to throw, Stafford.
And oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete.
This a very important drive, and that incompletion leads to a very important third down here if they're going to try and get the football back.
Yeah, getting it back, absolutely crucial to their chances to try and win this game. I would expect a lot of pressure here. They can't afford to let them continue to get first downs and eat away at the clock.
Every penalty so critical at this stage of the game as now they've got it third and long. Stafford. And that is incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
Here's Johnny Hecker now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And complete right side to Cook. And he'll be taken down, losing yardage back at the 9-yard line. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. Second and 11. Cousins. And a third interception thrown by Cousins. Picked off at the 17. And he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown.
Little bit of a backbreaker right there. You're down close, one score game, trying to push the ball down the field and score, and you throw a pick six.
And sometimes you take a little bit of a gamble when you're making your throws, right? Sometimes you press it a little bit more than maybe you wanted to because you want that score so badly. In this case, it cost them.
And the Vikings able to recover. The hands team does its job. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to need a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
And once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. To throw on second and 10, Cousins. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, so they got the score. Do you go for one here and save the possible two-point conversion for later?
I think you do, because if you go for two here and you don't get it, that's deflation.
Yeah.
Now you wonder why you're even going for it. Take the easy one now and come back and try and get it later.
So now here are the Vikings faced with a big two-point conversion attempt. Here's Cousins. Being chased out left.
And that's incomplete. So unable to throw it in for two from the two. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending it?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage, put your heels on the goal line at worst. If they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head because they're going to run out of space because of the back of the end zone. Never let a guy catch one in front of you.
Stafford
escaping the pressure right.
He'll let this go for the end zone.
And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out.
Going deep for Hopkins.
And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need.
Mackenzie Alexander with a pick.
And the Vikings are right back in this football game.
Well, in all likelihood, this ball game's still over. I mean, even with the interception, two-score game, they need a miracle.
Curious decision to even throw the ball in that situation, but maybe they saw a stacked line of scrimmage and said, hey, it's better to try and throw it than to try and run against it. In any event, I think you're exactly right. Now, the other team can pad their stats, but I don't think they're going to win.
Yeah, but still, don't change it.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by David Long. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line.
With the points that we've seen scored, neither defense has been at their best, but these guys, they've been a little bit better, Charles, and a nice interception there.
Yeah, you're right about that, Brandon. Let's face it. It's not always how you start, it's how you finish, right? So maybe you have a rough game all the way along. If you make a big play like that at the right time, it can make everything turn out just okay.
This is caught. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. A big connection on that one. 31 yards.
Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal.
Stafford. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Another shot from the one on second and goal.
Stafford gonna throw it. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10.
Danielle Hunter in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
The Vikings gonna signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Stafford now to throw. And he's got it. That's Kupp for a Ram touchdown.
Cooper Kupp, his fourth touchdown. And the Rams look like they're about to put an end to their two-game losing streak as they add on to their lead.
Now Stafford will come up trying to get his guys a two-point conversion.
Stafford's going to try and throw for it. And the Rams are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
So they go with a pass there on the two-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their two-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is, and I don't know how much that one, that particular play factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15-16, that kind of changed things, didn't it?
It's really a part of everyone's strategy now. When I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they always talk about they actually have two-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
On first and 10, Cousins. And now here's interception. Picked off near the 42. Past the 20. And he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown.
And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed.